Hi everyone, it's Jen and I'm here today to do a color and chat, like an old school color and chat. I've disappeared for a while, I know, and the reason for that is because I was on vacation. I was at Disney World and I didn't want to broadcast that I wasn't going to be around, just for security purposes. And some of you have probably seen my pictures on Instagram that I was there. So I thought I would just do like a little update and do an old school color and chat, like I said, just to kind of give you guys a quick what's going on and how things have been going. And it's going to be literally an old school one. My son is here, as you can hear. So in a recent comment that I got from someone telling me he was super annoying and that not everybody wants to listen to that, and that I should really find a time to, you know, be without him and make my videos. So obviously the person that made the comment doesn't understand how it works when you have children, that you don't have a time without when you're not with them because you need to supervise them as a parent. So I'm just gonna say, if you don't like his noises and stuff like that, I get it. I know it's not for everyone, but just move along. My videos are not for you then. So anyway, I want to show you this. I just finished this. I had started this right before we went to Disney World. Literally the day before we went to Disney World, I started it. And I just finished it yesterday. I worked on it for Sammy's 48-hour color like nobody's watching marathon coloring thing. So I worked on that, and you might see some little lumps in here if you see the pictures. Let me see if I can actually zoom in a little bit. So you might see some little lumps and stuff in there. You see it right on his skin, like over here, and that's because of my copious amounts of stickle usage on the previous page when I did this. Now it's too big. Let me zoom back out. So there's a lot of stickles on this. Excuse me. And because of that, I had a little trouble coloring over some of the areas, but I made do and worked with it, and I used my Holbeins on this and my new pencil set that I got just on Saturday. We went to the Dick Blick store, and Frank got me the 24 Gold Faber. They're like a newer, it says studio quality, so they are lower grade. They're not artist grade, so they're a little bit cheaper. The Dick Blick is selling them like individually, so you can get them there individually for $1.25 each. So that's not bad. That's less than the Prismacolors, unless you buy six of the Prismacolors, and then I think they're $1.16 each. But yeah, so I tried them out in a new in a coloring book that I'm working on, and I just, like, let me grab it and I'll show you. Yeah, so filming is just not going very well today. Gonna muddle through. So what I'm working on with these pencils, or what I worked on last night, is I just did the rocks, and I was on the phone with my mom for 2 hours, and yes, that's all I did in the 2 hours that I was on the phone, but I was enjoying myself just chatting and like blending my pencils. So with these Gold Faber pencils, I only used on the rocks these three pencils, and for all of that time, I use these and didn't sharpen them once, and I can still use them and they don't need to be sharpened. So they are a harder pencil, but they're soft at the same time. They're just not, well, definitely not anywhere near soft as like the Holbeins or the Prismacolors, not at all. But they're really lovely pencils. I'm definitely going to be getting the bigger set. I'm going to order them directly from Dick Blick, because to get them from Amazon, you have to pay shipping, and I think they have to come internationally. So if you just wanted to get like a base of colors, there's enough to do pictures in this color, in this set. The only thing you're going to have a problem with is doing like skin colors, because this is the lightest pink that's in there, and it's a little bit dark for a base of a skin color. I think it would be good for blending. But I did see the singles in the store. They're $1.25 each in the store, and they do have some lighter colors. So with the whole set, the 48 set, I think you could use this as one pencil set and have enough, because it just, they blend really beautifully. They're supposed to have amazing blending abilities, waterproof, smudge proof, and they are supposed to be break proof because they are glued into the wood. That's according to what it says in the package. I don't know. I haven't had any break yet, but I haven't sharpened any yet either. So I'm not going to be continuing on with this picture because I need to reference the colors in Hey Hey, and I can't think of his name, but in order to finish this one. So I'm going to be doing that one on my own. So I'm not going to be working on that one, but I am going to be working in this book. And I just wanted to show you, in this picture, I used all Holbein's stickles, pebble chalk for the background, and I used the gold Fabers on the... on the flags. I am getting so many text messages and messages from all my friends here in the coloring community because, of course, there's always some kind of stuff going on, which I'm happily not involved with this time. So I am just going to go back to my filming here. I'll check on those messages in a bit. But I wanted to just do something kind of simple-ish today because I'm not going to get through a whole picture. Like I said, my coloring assistant is here. And I just wanted to give you guys an update on what's going on and my trip and all that kind of stuff. I've had a lot of requests for those of you guys that found out I was in Disney World for a trip update and stuff. So we're going to do some of that and talk about some other stuff. So I have extra pencils in this case. I bought some more Prismacolor pencils to replace like my skin tone colors and that because I've been working with those for my skin tones for most. So I put the newer pencils in my case and kept the old ones in here. And then I have like my favorite color from the Polychromos. And I have some of my favorite colors from the Koh-i Noors in here. My very favorite purple is this one from the Koh-i Noors. It's the red violet. It's such a pretty color. I have my Posca pen, my eraser pencils. I bought new Tagal sharpeners because mine were kind of dull. So it was a set of two for under $10. So I got them and I just marked them with stickers so I know which ones are the new ones. Typically lately I've just been getting rid of the dull ones, but I just like to have them marked. And then I have all my colors. I have all my pencils around. So my ones that I most frequently use, I have my Polychromos, I have my Holbeins, my Prismacolors, and now I have the new Gold Faber pencils. So I'm going to be starting off with the Gold Faber pencils just so that you can see how they work. So also, I wanted to just say a quick cheers to Anne Hatfield. I have my daily coffee. She'll know why that is a funny joke. So there's that. And let's go ahead and start. So what do I want to do here? I want to do, I don't know if I have a light enough color for them, but I'm going to actually try this one. Yeah, let's just go with this one. So I'm going to make the seals blue. So I'm just going to go in with, and these, by the way, don't have names, but they do have numbers. So this is 147. So, first to start off with, our trip was really nice. We were in Disney World from May 18th to the 23rd. And we've actually not been able to take longer trips because, as you guys know, I have three pugs. And my mother watches my pugs when I'm not home or when we go on vacation or something like that. And she also had two pugs. And when we booked the trip, she had one pug who is very elderly and was not in the best of health. So she would like sometimes have to carry him around and stuff like that. So, you know, with his troubles and my three, it's a lot of work for her. So we booked a shorter trip just because of, you know, she has a lot to do to take care of all of them. And unfortunately, her elderly pug passed away before we went on the trip. So she had a lot less to do this time. So we could have stayed longer, but we didn't change the trip. We just left it like it is because I always like to go with my father's old saying, which is stick with the plan. So that is what we did. So we went for... like I said, I think it was 6 days. Was it 6 days and five nights or something like that? Definitely not long enough anymore. Now that Emilio is getting older, he wants to do a lot more stuff. He wants to see. Let me zoom in a little bit. more. He wants to see rides 2 and 3 times and stuff like that, which we found out on this trip. So, yeah, next time, I've already spoken to her. She was like, oh, no, definitely go longer next time. I have no problem hanging out with your dogs. You know, she misses her own dogs. So it was nice that she got to hang out with my kids. And actually, 2 of my puppies are the sons of one of her dogs that passed away right before my birthday last year. So it was nice that she got to spend some time with them. Because during the day when she's here with Emilio, they are actually sleeping downstairs because they, Emilio chases after them and stuff like that. And they're a little bit older now. They're going to be 11 this year. Are they? Yeah, I think they're going to be 11 this year. Let's see, 14, 13, 12, 11. Belle's going to be, oh, geez, I think, is Belle going to be a teenager this year? Belle's, I think, going to be 12 this year, and the puppies are going to be 11. So, yeah, the puppies. So, yeah, so my mom got to hang out with them, and that was nice for her, and they enjoyed being with her, so that was good. And, so we had a nice trip. We stayed at the Wilderness Lodge. As you guys know, we love us the Wilderness Lodge. And Emilio is now calling it the Little House. And he keeps asking me to go back to the Little House. I was like, well, it costs money to go back to the Little House. But needless to say, he really enjoyed it. So we are already making plans to go back for our next trip because we didn't have the best trip this time. There was some problems with the hotel, which I'm not going to get into right now. Maybe in a future color and chat I'll talk about it. But this is not the first time that we've had the problems. We actually stayed on the concierge level this time. We've done it before. This is the third time that we did it. And the first time that we went, we absolutely loved it. It was so nice. They put out free food for the club level guests. That's what they call their concierge level, club level. So obviously you're paying extra. There's free food all day long, and at nighttime they put out wine and cheese and cordials and stuff like that. So, what, baby? Lion King? You want me to put the Lion King on? Okay, in a little bit I'll put it on, okay? When I'm done filming, okay? Yeah, okay? Okay, good boy. So we had some definite issues before we even arrived. And you know something, when you're paying those kind of prices to stay on their preferred level, their club level, you shouldn't have any problems. And this is the second time that this has happened to us where we've had problems. So that was that, and I'm not going to talk about that now because it's a long story, and I really don't want to get into that because I have other stuff to talk about, but it was a damper on the trip before we even got there, so I tried to get that resolved before we got there, which I did to some degree, but I was not pleased with what happened when we got there. Neither was Frank, and long and short of it is that we will not be going back to the Wilderness Lodge. I can't say ever. Because that is our favorite hotel, so it's like really disappointing that it happened this way. But definitely not to the club level again. I mean, we spent a lot of money to stay up there on the club level, and it should have been better than it was. And like I said, this is the second time, and I have complained to them before about the last experience that we had there, and they were very apologetic and very nice about it, and they actually gave us incentive to come back and try the club level again because of our displeasure. And they weren't pleased with the comments that I had made to them last time about what I didn't like. So they actually made it for us so that we could come back, and we did, and it was not any better, unfortunately. In fact, it was worse. So won't be doing the club level there again. Probably will be doing the club level at another hotel. I think the next time we go back, we're going to go back to the beach club. Last year we stayed at the beach club. We didn't do club level there, but we stayed at the beach club and we really enjoyed it. We find, and Amelia loves Epcot too now, so Frank and I find that we love Epcot. And from the beach club, you can actually just walk to Epcot. You don't need to take any transportation there. You are literally right over the bridge. And Emilio fell in love with my favorite ride, Figment this time. I love Figment, as you guys know. I actually have a Figment shirt on today. I know it's very close, but yeah, so I have a Figment shirt on today. And you guys know I love me, my Figment. And he fell in love with it. And as soon as we came off that ride, I go see Figment. That's what he calls it. I go see Figment. You want to go see Figment? Melio, what's your favorite ride in Disney World? Figment? You want to go to the Figment ride? Yeah. So he keeps asking to go back to the Figment ride. And trust me, kid, I'd love to go. But, so he liked that very much. And we love just hanging out at Epcot at night and doing the countries and stuff. And when you enter Epcot from the Beach Club, you walk right into the countries. So, I think for us, it's going to be a little bit better. We didn't spend as much time in the Magic Kingdom as I thought we would this trip. I thought we would spend more time there, being that, you know, Magic Kingdom is usually what the kids like the most. But he didn't ask to go on rides multiple times at the Magic Kingdom, which I was surprised at. The only thing he asked to go on multiple times there was Dumbo. He liked that. Yeah, Dumbo. He liked that a lot. And they had a play area. It was a really good idea, actually. If you didn't have a fast pass for Dumbo, you had to wait on the regular line, which is normal. And, still getting the text messages. And, excuse me. So what they did, though, now is if you have to wait on the regular standby line, you wait on this little line, which is maybe about 10 minutes, and then you enter this, like, tent. It's like a tent with air conditioning and all that. It's inside. And in the tent, they have a play area that looks like a circus for the kids. And they give you an actual beeper to come back when it's your turn to ride on Dumbo. It was ingenious. It was so nice that you didn't have to stand out in the hot sun waiting like for 25 minutes for Dumbo. The time flew once you got into the play area because, of course, you know, you have to watch kids. So you're not just sitting there like praying that the sun is not going to melt you. You're inside in a nice dark area for the kids because it looks like a circus tent. And they can play. There's Dumbo flying around in there. And it's so... Yeah, and it's so nice. So we went in there, and he had such a ball. And when the beeper went off for our turn to ride Dumbo, he started to cry. He didn't want to leave the play area. So we went to the desk, and we said, could we have... Yeah, we go to the little house, Emilio. Soon, buddy. So he started to cry. So we went to the desk, and asked him, we said, could we stay in the play area a little bit longer? And they were so nice about it. They were like, oh, sure. And they just extended it out another 10 minutes. So it was great. So he got to play in there, and then we got to ride on Dumbo, and it was really, I have to say, that was a really good idea. And he was just the right age for it, too. I think last year he just would have been a little too little to play in there. He would have been kind of intimidated. But this year he was great, and he really enjoyed it, and that was a fun thing. But that was the only ride at the Magic Kingdom that he asked to go on twice. We took him on some rides twice, but that was the only thing that he really, really liked. And he did like the Buzz Lightyear ride, which I kind of thought he would because he likes games. So we went on that twice. But there, that was the only thing he really did. So I'm actually going to skip ahead a little bit in the story, and maybe I'll come back and talk more about Disney World in a little bit or another video, because this is not going to be like crazy long. It is Memorial Day, and Frank is marching in the parade, but we are not going to the parade this year. We usually go every year unless it's raining, but this year, no, because those of you that are on the Facebook page will know this, but those of you not will have no clue. So in Disney World, today is Monday, so it was a week ago tomorrow. It was last Tuesday. Was it Tuesday? Yeah, it was Tuesday. I had a lot of trouble sleeping in Disney World. There were several reasons why, but The main thing is that their beds are extremely hard at the Wilderness Lodge. I don't ever remember it being this way, but I was in so much incredibly bad body pain. I hardly slept. Like, I really, the very first night, even though we were up at 3 a.m. to get on the plane by 6, the very first night, I think I slept 2 hours total because the beds were so hard, I had to keep turning. I had to get up during the night to take medicine because I could not stand the pain, and I very rarely have to get up to take medicine during the night. But I was in serious distress, and I could not get comfortable. So what I did was, after the first night, I called up. I went up to the concierge level. Actually, I didn't call up. I went up to the concierge, and I said, I'm having a horrible time sleeping in the bed because of my chronic pain. I said, is there a way that you could send me some more pillows so that I could try to prop myself up? Thank you, baby. And he was like, oh my gosh, I feel awful. He's like, I'll send you every pillow I can in the hotel. So they did. They sent up about 5 pillows. So I didn't sleep totally on top of the pillows because that wouldn't really be comfortable for me. But I did prop myself up, and I bought a Pillow Pal because I don't like, their pillows are very, they look like they're very fluffy. But when you lay down on them, those are the ones that just like get flat when you lay down on them. So I had bought a Pillow Pal, which I usually do every year anyway, because not only do I like to sleep on them when I'm there, but I sleep on them when I'm home too. So I always like to get a new fresh one if they have one that I like. So they don't last very long, maybe a few years, and then you have to replace them anyway. But you know, I'm a big kid at heart, so I got me a Pillow Pal. Which was very helpful. And then I propped myself up on the pillows, but I still had a problem. I still had a problem sleeping in the bed. It was, I'm sorry, more messages. My apologies. Thank God I turned the sound off my phone. So anyway, I still had a problem sleeping in the bed. I was only getting maybe 4 or 5 hours a night. And for anybody that knows like chronic fatigue syndrome, chronic pain, obviously I have fibromyalgia, I have chronic fatigue syndrome, I have Sjogren's syndrome, and I have psoriatic arthritis. Although when I talk to people, I usually just leave the Sjogren's syndrome out when they ask me because I don't really want to explain it. It's a weird disease that causes weird crap. So it's easier just to explain stuff that people know. So so I have all this going on, and I can't sleep. And those of you that suffer from this kind of stuff know that sleep is essential to getting your body back to some sort of functioning way in the morning. If you don't sleep, you're not only bitchy, but you are completely out of it. You're just like, you're barely functioning. And I was barely functioning. One morning, I was up at 4 o'clock in the morning, wide awake, because I could no longer sleep. I stayed in the room, even though I was awake, I stayed in the room until, I think I just got a delivery. I stayed in the room until 5:30, and I was like, I can't take it anymore. All I was doing was tossing and turning, and if I turned the lights on, I would have woken up Frank and Amelia, which I'm sure Frank wouldn't have minded, but everybody needed their rest. So I was like, all right, I'm going to go downstairs. So I took my Nook with me, and I went and I read a book, and I finished a book downstairs. I got myself some coffee, and I just sat by the quick service place and had some coffee for like 2 hours, and then I brought Frank up some coffee when I knew he would probably be getting up. So we were supposed to have our friends come and visit, and I was just feeling really awful, and so they didn't end up coming to visit. I think actually my friend is not like happy about it. I think she's kind of annoyed about it, and I feel really bad about it, but there was nothing I could do. I just felt really crappy. I had barely slept, and I was not feeling good, and I said, this sucks, because it was only like the third day. And I said, how am I going to function on the rest of this trip? So I just want to point out to you guys, I'm going to bring it up a little bit higher so you can see. Do you see how nice these blend for not artist grade pencils? I think they blend really nice, actually, and they're so nice to work with. I don't have to put any heavy pressure down. I like these a lot. I cannot wait to get the other set. So anyways, getting back to my story. So that was, what day was that? That was Sunday. And I continued on. Another problem that we had was the horrendous rain. There was a lot, and I mean a lot of rain. The very first night we were there, we went over to the Magic Kingdom, and we wanted to watch the fireworks. And as we were watching the fireworks, it started to rain a little bit, but nothing that you, like, couldn't handle. Didn't even really need a poncho. It was just kind of, like, misting and stuff like that. Well, all of a sudden, the skies opened up, and it rained harder than I think I've ever seen there before in my life. It was like a torrential rain, and we were out in the middle of it. And we were taking the boat back to the hotel, because that's what you do from the Wilderness Lodge. And it was raining so hard. We were soaked down to our underwear. And there was, like, just nothing that we could do to stop getting that wet, because it was just raining that hard. So we didn't really mind, though, because we knew we were going back to the hotel. And, you know, the day was over. So that was that first night. And then it rained on and off all day long the second day. Which was Saturday. Sunday, it rained a lot in the morning. It just did. It rained a lot in the morning. In the afternoon, it started to clear up. We went over to Epcot, and I had slept all morning, and Frank kept Emilio down at the club level because they had a big TV for the kids that played Disney Junior all day long. So he was in his glory. They had a coloring station for the kids, and then, like I said, they have the free food. So Frank and him were totally entertained the whole time while I needed to sleep. So he took him down there, and I rested all morning into the afternoon. And then I finally got up a little after 12, and we went over to Epcot. And we were there, I guess, about an hour, and again, it started to downpour. So we were in Mouse Gears shopping, which is like the big shopping store in Epcot, and we came out, and it's like between, there's a little like a rest area, sort of like a little place where they have benches and stuff between Mouse Gears and the restaurant. So we ended up sitting on the floor on the concrete with everybody else, because everybody else was doing the same thing, because you just could not go out in it. It was like if you put ponchos on, you were still going to be soaked. So we had to just sit there and wait it out. And that rain was a long one. That was like 2 hours. And then finally, it didn't stop raining, but it let up enough for us to make a break for it. So we did. And we went back to the hotel because it was just like crazy, crazy rain. And we were all wet and had to change my hair. If I ever moved to Florida, my hair would never look good again. Let's put it like that, because the humidity was horrendous. The rain was constantly in my hair. And I was just like, this sucks, because my hair, I had it looking so nice. I got it all blown out the day before we went, because I didn't want to do it myself. I just wanted to get it done, and I had it done, and it looked so pretty. And I got there, and it not only poofs out, but it gets totally rained on every day. So I ended up having to wash it and doing it myself anyway. So I think I learned a lesson there, that I'm not going to get my hair blown out before I go to Disney World, because it doesn't last. I might as well just do it myself and save the money. But anyway, so yeah, it was a lot of rain, and so that brings us down to Monday. I was really feeling awful. I'm not really quite sure what was wrong, other than the fact that I knew that my monthly visitor was on its way, and I had brought provisions with me just in case, because I knew that it was due anytime. It actually, unfortunately, came a day early, so there was that to contend with. So I figured, okay, well, I have it now, and, you know, eventually I'm going to start feeling better. Tuesday morning, I woke up at, like, 3 o'clock in the morning with left shoulder pain and pain in my chest. Sorry, another message. So, I woke up with left shoulder pain and pain in my chest. I wasn't having trouble breathing or anything like that, but I was having really bad chest pain. And I said, what the hell is this now? So I was getting kind of scared, but it happened to me one other time in my life. It was after I had to go to court for a ticket, and I had never been to court before. And I literally freaked myself out so bad that I had a panic attack where it mirrored the symptoms of having a heart attack, because I even had, like, pain in my arm. And I had gone to the emergency room This is way before Frank and I were married, but Frank and I were dating at the time. And he came all the way in from Long Island because I lived in Queens, because I told him, I don't know if I'm having a heart attack or what. So my father had a massive heart attack and died in my living room. So, you know, there's that fact that, you know, there's obviously a heart problem in the family. And my grandmother, my mother's mother, who I seem to take after, who had tons of illnesses her whole life, she had heart failure. So I kind of, even though I'm young, I don't want to play around with that kind of stuff. You know, if something's going on, I want to be alert and aware about it. I have a young child now. I have a husband who depends on me. I need to watch what I'm doing and make sure that, you know, I'm taking care of myself. And if I see something like this, to say something, because I really believe that if my father would have said something, if we would have known what was going on with him, he'd still be alive. Well, maybe not still be alive today, but that wouldn't have taken him down. In other words, you know, we would have got it taken care of. But since he didn't tell what was going on, we had no idea that he was having chest pains and all this stuff for months. So regardless, I started having all these pains and I'm saying, what the hell is going on? And I was just laying there like trying to figure out what is going on here. You know, do I need to call attention to this? And then the pain starts moving. Like it's moving from my chest. It's moving. It's making me nauseous. It's like moving to my shoulder. Then it's moving to my arm. And I'm saying it's not all in the same place. It's like literally moving from place to place. And it's serious. It's like I have a vice on my body. And I'm like, what the heck is happening? So I told Frank. I didn't wake him up, but I did tell him when he got up. And I had been taking my medicine. It wasn't helping at all. And it was really making me worried. But I didn't let on to the fact that I was really worried about it, because Frank will immediately just like call an ambulance. And I hate that kind of like, I don't know, attention. I don't know. Ever since I went to the hospital the one time and I found out it was just a panic attack, I guess it did something to me where I was like, oh God, am I like doing the whole henny penny, the sky is falling in, you know? So I kind of, unless I really think something's happening, I'm probably not going to draw too much attention to it. I did say something about it, but I didn't make it like into a big deal, in other words. So I kept watching it, and I think I've told you guys, I'm allergic to ibuprofen. I wasn't always, but somehow I developed an allergy to it, where I was getting the hives and stuff, and it would make my heart race, and I really honestly just was like, you know what, F it. I'm taking an ibuprofen, because Frank had them with him. He gets headaches sometimes, so he carries them with him, and I didn't have any, but I knew he did, so I went into his case, and I took just one. And it didn't give me the hives, and my heart didn't start to race or anything, so I said, okay, I must be all right with at least just one. And I took one, and the pain got better. And I know that you're supposed to take a Tylenol or like acetaminophen or something like that if you're having a heart problem, like you think you're suspecting a heart attack or something. And the Tylenol wasn't helping, and I said, this is interesting, because if the ibuprofen's helping, it must be some sort of inflammation. But again, I wasn't sure. So I didn't really say much, and I just continued on about the day, but I had this horrendous pain. So that was Tuesday. We were leaving on Wednesday. I woke up on Wednesday still with the terrible pain. And I have to say, as far as the beds go, yes, I had horrible pain, but Frank also complained about being stiff and his back hurting from the beds. So I know it wasn't just me, and I thought maybe this is related to the bed. We had gone on the Toy Story ride twice during the week, and I thought... So as I was saying, we went on the Toy Story Mania ride at the studio two times, and that kind of jostles you around. It's the only ride we went on that like jostles you around. I don't go on any of the other rides anymore because they hurt. So not any of the other rides, but like the roller coasters and stuff, anything that's gonna like jostle you around, I don't go on anymore because it hurts my body. So I started thinking maybe that ride gave me a pinched nerve in my shoulder, because it does toss you around a little bit. And you know, stranger things have happened, so I thought, well, maybe that's what it is. but why would it hurt in my chest? And I'm like, I don't know. So we went to bed on Tuesday night. Wednesday, I woke up at 4 o'clock in the morning again, and my arm hurt. And I said, holy crap, I must be having a heart attack. And I'm laying there thinking about it, and I'm like, what do I do? Do I wake up Frank? What do I do? Should I wait a little bit longer? And then I realized as I was laying there, I'm like, you know what? You're giving yourself a panic attack, which is going to mirror the heart attack thing. I was like, so calm down first before you do anything. So I got up out of bed, and I just stood and looked out the balcony at the pool, and I could feel myself, like my muscles were super tight. And I said, that's what's causing this tightness, is the muscles. Because anybody that has fibro knows your muscles are always tight, like so tight all the time. If I stretch my legs out enough every morning, I get a Charlie horse. It's just, your muscles are always tight like that. So I started to calm myself down, and the tightness in my arm started going away. So I said, okay, well, you're panicking, and that's what that is about. So I went back to bed, and I got up, and I took more Advil, and I started to feel better again, like it was going away. So I said, okay, I guess it is some sort of inflammation or whatever. I continued on. We went to the Magic Kingdom, and guys, I felt like complete and total crap on the last few days of the trip. I did not want to go out to any parks or do any walking. I really just wanted to stay in the room. And the worst part of it is, at the end of the day, when you feel like crap, you know at least you can get in your own bed and get comfy and cozy and either color or read or do whatever you like to do, watch TV. And I knew that at the end of the day, getting in that bed was just going to be so much more torture. Like, I wasn't going to get any good rest. I couldn't cuddle. It was really awful. Not to be a Debbie Downer, but that's the truth. When you don't feel good, you just want your own surroundings. You want your own comfort. And I just wanted to get into my own bed and just be so comfortable. And I knew that getting into this bed was not going to be any kind of resolution for me. So there was that, too, on my mind that I was like, oh, God, this totally sucks. So Wednesday, I did what I had to do. My child, I wanted him to see everything that we could possibly see. The only ride we had not taken him on was the Pirates of the Caribbean, and I wanted to take him on that because he's into pirate stuff. And I said, I'll be damned. So I got up, I got dressed, I packed up the suitcases. We lugged the suitcases downstairs and so that they could hold them, and off we went to the Magic Kingdom, and we spent the whole morning there until it was time to go back and get the bus to the airport. And I had the pain on and off, and every time I took like the ibuprofen, which you can only take 6 in a day, I felt better. But I knew I had to go on the plane, and I was like a little concerned about it, but I said, okay, well, whatever's gonna happen is gonna happen. So we got on the plane, and everything was pretty much fine. I have to take Dramamine to go on the plane because I think it's more of a psychological thing than anything else, but I'm always afraid I'm going to throw up because I think I told you guys I'm deathly afraid of throwing up for some stupid reason. So it's more of a really psychological thing. I don't actually think I'll throw up, but I know that when I take the Dramamine that I won't get nauseous, so I just take it anyway. And it puts me out. Like, I literally am just knocked out. I'm like dead to the world. And so I did get to sleep on the plane for like 2 hours. And we got home, and I was so excited to be in my own bed and everything. I laid down. I can't get comfortable. This pain in my arm is excruciating, like my shoulder, not my arm. And like I said, it moves down to my chest, and I'm like, I cannot get comfortable. I put a pillow under my arm to try to prop up my arm and lay on my side. I can't get comfortable. I'm sleeping still only like 2 to 3 hours a night. So, you know, I don't know what to do. My pain management doctor is always heavily booked. So I knew I wasn't going to be able to get by him, especially right before a holiday weekend. So I was like, should I just call him? What should I do? As I told you previously, my primary care doctor retired, and unfortunately, I have not found a new one yet. I need to do that better than what I've been doing. I haven't really honestly been looking. So I don't have a primary care doctor, and my only other option is to go to the hospital. And I don't want to go to the hospital because I don't know if it's warranted to that. And if I call an ambulance, everybody from the fire department is going to show up here. And I cannot, like, unless I need it, I'm not doing that. Because it's just embarrassing for me. You know, I don't want everybody looking at me like, what is wrong with her or whatever. It's just me. It's just an insecurity. I just don't want that. It's too much attention for something that I don't know what's happening. So I guess another day passed and I was still going through this. I was sucking down any kind of medicine I could find, my pain medicine, my ibuprofen, Tylenol. You know, I'm watching obviously the amounts I'm taking to make sure I'm not going over the limits or anything like that. So don't worry. But I was literally like taking it like it was candy. It was not doing anything for me. And I'm saying, I got to do something about this. Something is wrong. So what's today? Today's Monday, so Sunday. Saturday night, Frank and I were sitting on the couch talking. We had been watching the, I don't know if you saw it on the Oxygen channel, the Casey Anthony or the Kaylee Anthony case revisited to look at all the evidence again. And Frank actually was not familiar with that story at all. So for him, it was all brand new. I actually had listened to an audiobook from the state prosecutor. So I had a good idea about a lot of the stuff from the case, but it's intriguing, obviously. We don't ever know what happened to that little girl. We all can speculate, but we don't know. So I will always watch those kinds of things, like the Lacey Peterson. We don't know what happened to her either. And I will always watch those kinds of true crime shows. They're like just fascinating to me. So I said, I had taped it. I set it up to tape when we were away. So I said to Frank, you interested? So he was interested to watch, and he really got really into it because, like I said, it was all brand new to him. He didn't know anything about it. He had never heard of it before. So we were watching that, and then, like I said, I couldn't sleep. So I've been staying up till like 2 or 3 in the morning, which is terrible because I have to go back to work tomorrow. So I have to really kind of stop that. But anyway, so I was staying up. We were chatting, and my back was itchy. So I said to him, I was like, could you look at this on my back? Because I had gone to the bathroom to see if like there was a pimple or a bug bite or whatever. And there was this huge welt on my back. And I said, what the hell is this? And it was itchy. So I said to him, could you put some Benadryl cream on this for me? So he did. And I couldn't see it very well. So I said to him, what is that? Is that a bug bite or what? And he's like, it looks like little... he said, it's big. It's a welt. He's like, it looks like a burn. And I'm like, a burn? He's like, yeah, it looks like it's got all these little red dots in it. Like it's going to bleed. And I was like, well, I haven't fallen or anything like that. So I had no clue what this was all about. But, you know, weird stuff happens to me all the time. So I didn't think too much about it. I figured it was just some kind of bug. And then I started getting paranoid. Like, did the hotel have bed bugs and stuff? But, excuse me. I was like, I don't know. So, he put the cream on it for me. It stopped itching and I didn't really think much about it. And then I started thinking on the trip, I was wearing a crossbody bag and my back hurt in that same spot where the crossbody bag was. And I kept thinking all week, there must be a pimple there. Cause that's what it felt like there was a pimple on my back. And I kept looking in the mirror, I didn't see anything. And I said, this is so weird. And then when we came home, like I said, I found that thing. And I said, oh, this must be a pimple. But it was huge. So I said, all right. And I hadn't put the cream on it. And that was it. And then I didn't think about it again. So that was Saturday night. And it wasn't itching me. So again, I didn't think about it. So Sunday, I did some coloring. I'm still having all the pain and everything. And then for some reason, Sunday night, it was late. It was like, I don't know, 11 o'clock, maybe later than that. I said, let me go check on that thing and see like what that looks like. And all of a sudden I have a rash all over my back, like on my back and on my left side. And I said, what the hell? So I start looking at it and looking at it in the mirror and I'm like, oh my God, this must be bed bugs. This is disgusting. Now we have bed bugs from the hotel. I have bites all over me. And I'm like, wait a minute. I didn't itch or anything when I was there. And, this would have taken longer, like it would have come out sooner than what's happening here. So I'm looking at it and I'm like, is this all pimples? And I'm like, no, pimples don't look like this. And then it hit me. I said, I have the shingles. And I came downstairs to Frank and I showed him. I said, look at this. I said, I think I have the shingles. And he's like, what's the shingles? So I explained it to him. And for those of you that don't know what the shingles are, it's, if you've ever had chicken pox, you are susceptible to the shingles. The shingles are like sort of like adult chicken pox, but 150 million times worse. They are extremely painful. And they look just like the chicken pox. They get onto your skin like a rash, and like they attach to a nerve. So if your nerve is going through your body like this, you're going to get the rash along the nerve. And you usually only get it on one side of your body. So I said to him, you know, we don't have an urgent care. So I said to him, we don't have a primary doctor. So I said, all right, we have to go to urgent care tomorrow. They should be able to diagnose this if that's what it is, especially because now there's a rash. They can see it, you know. So he went to the firehouse yesterday, and I went, yes, firehouse, and I went and got my nails done with my mom, and then my mom came back to the house and watched Emilio for us, and we went to the urgent care, because there's only, like, I'm sure by you it's the same thing, but there's only, like, 500 urgent cares all over the place over here. So I had been to one before when I had a UTI a few years ago, so we went to the same one because they had my information. And doctor came in, she took one look, she's like, yep, you have the shingles. So I said, I kind of thought I did. And in the morning when I was looking at it, I noticed now I had it all under my breast. And that's exactly where the pain had been for all of these days that I had been suffering. One second. So before I talk more about the shingles, I also want to mention that I got a cold in Disney World. So you probably hear me coughing and my voice sounds a little off. I have a runny nose, but more than anything, I have a cough, and it's one of those coughs that starts out really dry, and it ends up getting really crappy, and every time you lay down, you start hacking up a lung. So yeah, I have that going on too. Lovely. And, you know, so, all right, let me continue on with the story here with the shingles. So she gave me, an antiviral. I think it's called Valtrex or something like that. So she gave me that. Usually, like typically they're supposed to give a cream, like a lidocaine cream or something for this. But she didn't give it to me because, they are all kind of like, all doctors and facilities are really anti giving you any kind of pain, anything, because of all the addiction problems in the country right now, which is fine because I have a pain management doctor, so I wouldn't expect her to give me anything like that. I just needed to get a diagnosis of what this actually is and get some sort of, I knew I needed like an antiviral just from looking up information about the shingles. So she did give me those things. And, the story about the shingles is really this. It's you are going to have pain, which I already have. Like I told you, I've been suffering over for a week with this pain. So I have that going on already. And it sucks. It hurts. It's horribly painful. I feel like my shoulder and my chest are in a vice, and all of a sudden it starts squeezing on the inside. The sores hurt also, like chicken pox do. It's kind of the same thing. They're going to open, they're probably going to ooze, and then they have to crust over. And I am highly contagious until that happens. So luckily, my little Emilio has had the chicken pox vaccine. I've gotten him every vaccine with the exception of the flu vaccine because I'm just not really sure about that one. Because I told you about the Guillain-Barré thing. So, because my grandmother had the Guillain-Barré thing, I have refused the flu shot for him up until now, which I'm not really all that worried about because, like, he's not in daycare, and also, the flu vaccine was only 10% effective this year, so I never had the flu vaccine, and I don't feel comfortable giving it to him when that paper said if you've ever had Guillain-Barré, you shouldn't have it. Now, obviously, knock wood, and thank God, he's never had it. I've never had it. But I'm a sickly person like my grandmother, and it obviously is in our family. And It's an autoimmune disease, and I have several autoimmune diseases, and he was inside of me while I've had the autoimmune diseases. So odds are he could be carrying something, and I just don't feel comfortable with the flu shot at this time. Maybe I might change my mind later on. We will see. I don't know. But either way, he's had all his other vaccines, and he had the chickenpox vaccine just this year. So I asked the lady at the care, I said, is he safe from it? And she said, yes. And I said, okay. And then I was supposed to see my mother-in-law last night to celebrate her birthday. And my mother-in-law has had organ transplant last year. And I said, am I safe to be near her? And she said, no. She said, you should not be near her. She's in the age where she could contract the shingles anyway. She's like, and she probably has a compromised immune system because of the transplant. She's like, so I would not advise you being near her. Plus my father-in-law is older and frail and he's got some health issues. So I just didn't want to go to that dinner and expose them to any of this, especially because this whole rash just came out. So it is sore on your wherever you have it. And it's like in your bones and your nerves. It's awful. It hurts so much. I can't even believe I'm standing here talking to you guys like this, but I really wanted to get the video out to you just to let you know why I might or might not be here all that often in the interim. But it's really painful, and the sores hurt, and it's Monday, but because today's Memorial Day, my pain management doctor is obviously not there. So I'm going to call them tomorrow and see, because I'm not actually scheduled to see him again until July. And I don't think I can continue on this way, because as it's been explained to me from both the doctor and what I read online with the shingles, is that once it starts clearing up, you most likely will have some leftover residual pain for some time. And it's like I think it's called post-neuralgia pain or something like that. It's something having to do with the nerves and leftover pain from this. And because of that, it can be severe. It can stay for a week. It can stay for 3 weeks. It can stay for a few months. It can stay for a year. It can go right away. You cannot get it at all. And I already have this pain that's awful, and I'm worried, like, is it going to get worse? If it's going to get worse than this, I'm going to be incapacitated, because I was barely just making it like I was. Yeah, I'm coloring it green. So I'm going to call them tomorrow and see what they say. But, Frank came into the bedroom yesterday when we came back from the doctor and was saying he just felt so bad, and he looked like he was going to cry. He didn't cry, but he looked like that. He had that sad look on his face, and I said, what's up? And he was like, how much can one person take? He's like, you just deal with all of this stuff and it just keeps happening to you. He's like, and on top of it, he's like, not only with the shingles, he's like, but you have a cold too. He's like, this is ridiculous. And he's like, I'm worried about how much you can actually bear. And I said to him, I was like, well, don't worry about that. I was like, this isn't the worst of things that could happen. It could be much worse than this, for sure. I said, so this is something that will go away eventually. It might be right away. It might not. But it is something that will go away. And this is not the worst that can happen. And he's so sweet for his concern. And my mom was so sad too. She felt exactly the way he did when I called her last night to chat, because I couldn't go to the dinner last night. He took Emilio with him, so it was just me and the dogs, and I called her to chat, and she said, she's like, I just feel so down. She's like, I don't know how to help you. She's like, and you just keep getting hit with thing after thing. And I'm young to have the shingles, but I'm not the youngest person that's ever had them. I mean, it's typically an older people's disease. But even the doctor yesterday at the urgent care, she said, we're seeing younger and younger people coming in with this. She's like, because people are just getting immune to medicines and our immune systems are compromised and stuff. So, I mean, it's true. The flu is killing people. So it's definitely a truth, and, well, I have it. So We just have to deal with it. It's just another thing to deal with, another pain to deal with. It's not fair. You know, nobody should have to deal with more and more pain. And I'm a bit concerned about the residual pain because I already have bad pain from the fibromyalgia and the psoriatic arthritis. So I'm a little concerned about that, but I know that I have total faith in my pain management doctor to help me. So all I need to do is get in touch with them and... Yes, buddy. And you know, find out what they're going to do or what I should do, what they advise, and we'll just go from there. But saying all that, just to tell you that I don't know what's going to be happening with me, to be honest with you. I don't know how this is going to affect me. I'm doing the best that I can, and I'm, excuse me, and I'm trying to just be positive about it, know that it will be going away, and I won't have to deal with this forever, but it's painful right now, and it will be painful afterwards, and I'm taking my medicine, doing everything I'm supposed to do, but it is what it is, and somebody on the Facebook page said people should get their shingles vaccines, which I totally agree. They have it now. You can get it. But we were told in multiple places that we went to yesterday, because we tried to get it for Frank, that they will not give it to anyone under 50. So, yeah. So he couldn't get it. So there was nothing that we could really do about it. And unless you're over 50, you're probably not going to get the shingles vaccine. We even went to CVS, and they told us the same thing, because they do give the vaccine out there, and they wouldn't give it to him. So he even told them, he said, I mean, they were filling my medicine, and he's like, my wife actively has the shingles right now, and they were like, how old is she? And he said, she's 38, and they were like, oh, well, we can't give it to you, because it's not in the guidelines. So... Yeah, but is what it is. We will make do, and we will continue on. But I just wanted to give you guys those brief little updates to just tell you that I am around, and I am going to be doing the giveaways. I'm just, again, having health issues that are quite surprising and something that I've been dealing with for the last few weeks and didn't even know it was coming on. So with all of that, you know, I had that happening and didn't even know it. And I think that's what kind of was a damper on part of the trip, because I was getting sick and I didn't even realize it. So although we did have a good time, it wasn't the best of trips, and I'm not going to plan anything right now, but I am going to plan something for the near future to go back to Disney World, go to a different hotel when I'm feeling better, and, you know, give it another try and see how it is. It's not going to be any time over the summer, because I cannot stand the freaking humidity and heat down there. I can't believe we actually consider moving down there at one time. I cannot stand that humidity and the heat. So although I love Florida, I'm getting too old to deal with the heat and the humidity. Maybe if I get old, and I do say maybe because there's no guarantee I'm going to get old, but maybe if I get old and I become one of those people that is always cold all the time, Florida will be an ideal place for me. But at this time, I still need my winter. I love the winter, and I still need that every year. So I will not be moving to Florida anytime soon. It's just not going to be in the cards. But I'm going to plan another trip, probably for the winter time. My mom already said she'd watch the dogs, and when I'm feeling better, I'll start planning, and we'll take another trip and try to make up for what we missed on this trip because of my health issues. And I have a plan for the next time. If the bed in the next place that we go to is very hard, I'm going to order some extra blankets, and I'm going to lay the blankets down sort of like a comforter and sleep on top of them that way and see if that helps, because I think that could be a good option for pain control. So sorry to keep coughing in your ear. I just can't help it. It's like one of those itchy coughs that you get. And I've been talking so much. And yeah, so that's happening. So I have now given you a brief update on Disney World. I can definitely talk more about it. I have so many more things to talk about things that we did and things that we saw and changes that we saw and stuff and how Emilio reacted to everything. But this video is already like an hour, a little bit over an hour, and I am not gonna make it any longer than this, because I think that over an hour videos, not, you know, there's so many people that make such long videos and not everybody has time to watch all of them. So I kind of want to just make it as short but informative as possible to let you know what's going on and what is happening. And you can always find me on our Facebook page or on my Instagram. My Instagram is Reading with Pugs. I do post all of my pictures and my book stuff and some family stuff on Instagram. So if you want to find me there, please do. Or you can look in the description below and you can find the information for our Facebook group. I hope to be back for another color and chat pretty soon, or another vlog, depending on whatever we're doing. I do like doing the vlogs so much. It's kind of an escape from all the like drama and crazy stuff that goes on in the coloring community, that I just don't want any part of that. So it's nice that I have that little outlet that I don't have to, I don't know, it's kind of separate from just the drama stuff. And I like doing them a lot. They're fun. You know, there's a little bit of everything of my life and what we do, and it's just fun to do those. I like them. I like doing them. So I would like to get back to doing them as well. It's just I haven't really either had the time or been up to it recently. But I will be doing those giveaways, so stay tuned for those. And just stay tuned for the next adventures of Jen's health life. So that is it for now. I'm going to zoom out a little bit. As you can see, I only worked with the gold Farber pencils on this one. I did use a cream and a white from my regular Polychromos because I just think I like them better. Well, there's no cream in this one, but the white I think I like better. It's just a little bit softer in this one. But as you can see, for not artist grade pencils, these work pretty nice. They blend pretty good. They don't feel hard in your hand, like it's too hard to work with or anything like that. I like them a lot. I can't wait to get the whole rest of the set so that I can use them along with the Holbeins and just combine them up, and they'll work really nice together. So I'm going to go. I need to take my medicines, and I have to just show you guys this. One of the medicines that I have, which is not the the prednisone, but the other one, the Valtrex or whatever the heck it is. It's the antiviral. Look at the size of these things. They're huge. They're horse pills. Look at that. That is a big old pill. So I have to take those 5 times a day. Those are 3 times a day. I have to take the prednisone 5 times a day. Yeah, it's not a good situation I have going on here. I'm itchy. I'm in pain. So I'm just trying to work through it right now and be the best person that I can be in the meantime and just do whatever I can do. So I appreciate you guys taking the time to watch this today. I know it was a bit of a long video. I hope you enjoyed the coloring part of it and the chat that I did. And if you are interested to hear more about our Disney trip and what happened at the Wilderness Lodge, I'd be more than willing to do that in another color and chat and just talk about it. I'm sorry if my health issues are a downer. It's just what I have going on right now. So just being honest with you guys. And again, I thank you for watching, and I look forward to the next video that I can do and chatting with you guys, and I will see you all in my next video.